everyone. So today I want to do a casual get ready with me. I hauled a bunch of new products, and if you haven't seen that, I will link that down below. And I wanted just to use some of them just to get ready. So if you're interested, please keep on watching. So I washed my face and I used the L'Oreal Hydrogenous for oily skin. This is what it looks like. So I put that on my skin already. It feels really, really nice. I really like this. Very lightweight, really great. I'm enjoying it, so. So to prep my skin, I'm gonna go in with the NYX First Base Setting Spray. Gonna let that dry. So for primer, I'm gonna use this. It's the Milani Prime Perfection Face Primer, hydrating and pore minimizing. I'm gonna check this out. I have a little dryness on my cheek area. It's so weird because I get dry on the outsides of my face, but I'm really oily on my nose. So weird. My face cannot get it together with what it wants to do. So just to kind of fill in my pores on the sides of my nose and help with the oil, I'm gonna go in with the Dr. Brandt Pores No More. And this is a little trial size, really. I'm really testing it out to see if I like it before I jump ship and buy the full size, because it's expensive. So. So now I am going to try these out. These are the Wet n Wild cushions, but they're the color correcting cushions. So I have the for dark circles and for redness, which is the green and the peach color. So there's the peach, and then here's the green. All right, so I'm gonna go in first with the peach corrector. I'm just gonna use my finger and take what's on the lid here, and then I'm gonna go right underneath my eyes and just pat it. Ooh, that's really pigmented. Can I dab it? And then with the other eye? Mom, so I have really bad dark circles. So bad. Alright, just like that. It's very creamy. It doesn't have a scent, so that's great. And I'm going to go in with the green now. I'm just gonna use my finger again and go over. I've got some scarring from some zits I've had. And I have natural rosacea on my chin, family genetics, and on my cheek area. The cushion feels very saturated. I'm just gonna really pat this in with my finger. I'm kind of liking this. I mean, we'll see how foundation goes over it, but I think it's gonna work well. So I'm gonna try out this new foundation. It's new to me. I know it did come out a while ago. It is the Milani Conceal and Perfect 2-in-1 foundation, and I chose the shade 02 Natural. Okay, comes with a pump, which I am all for. So I'm gonna put it on my little tray here, and then I'm going to use the new Real Technique sponge, the pink one that's shaped weird, just like that. So I'm gonna use this one today. And then I'm just gonna probably dab this first, and then I'm gonna bounce. As you see, you can't even see that. The color correcting from Wet n Wild, it just gets covered right up. If you can hear, my husband and my son are downstairs. I think my son's eating lunch. Well, he should be. So having this on my skin now, I really like the way that it looks. It looks really nice. It covered pretty well. Like, there's a few things that it didn't quite cover up, but on all, my skin looks really well. Looks like really smooth, and yeah, I'm liking this. I really like it, so I'll have to try it a few more times. But so far, I'm liking it. So for my eyelid primer, I'm gonna use my absolute favorite, the Milani Eyeshadow Primer. And this one isn't just nude. I think they only have one color, but that's what shade it's in. And then I'm just gonna all over my eyelids up to my brow bone. Alrighty, and now for concealer, I'm going to use my absolute favorite, the Rimmel Match Perfection concealer in the shade Fair Light. So I'm just gonna squeeze this up. It may look like a lot, but I only squeeze up a little bit and then I spread around with a little brush or whatever is left, like inside the brush. A little bit on my nose. So for blending out my under your eye, I am going to blend it out with the Little Purple Sponge for Under the Eye by Real Techniques. So I'm just going to go with the pointed part and go. Just like that. And now I'll do that to the other eye. Alright, for setting my under eye area, I'm going to use the Maybelline Master Fix Translucent Powder. And I'm just going to take my brush and then I tap out underneath my eye to make sure there's no creasing. And then I take a brush with the product and put it underneath my eye. And then I take a little bit more and go over the whole area to set it. And then I also set my eyeshadow primer at the same time. Tap it to make sure there's no creasing. And set it very gently because your under eye is sensitive. And then I go all along. So setting my face, I'm going to use the e.l.f. Beautifully Bare Finishing Powder. And this is in the shade Fair Light. Ooh, that's really light. And then I'm just gonna take a fluffy brush here and just lightly go over my face. So now I'm gonna do my brows. So I'm gonna just comb through them really quickly. To fill in my brows, I'm going to use the e.l.f. Brow Pencil in Taupe. It's just like that. And I'm just going to fill in my brows. And then for brows, I'm going to use the Maybelline Brow Precise Fiber Volumizer. Man, that's the thing. And this is in the shade, let's see, medium brown. It's got the weirdest brush. I've seen Young Wild and Polished, Nicole, talk about this, and I was like, I need to try it. So, let's see how this is. It's definitely the perfect color for my brows. I definitely like to have a cooler color in my brows. Say it's pretty good. Kind of liking it. It's a weird brush, but it works. This is definitely better than the other brow product they came out with that weird brush. This is definitely a lot better. Alrighty, now for eyeshadow, I was lucky enough at my local Fred Meyer, they had just put out the new display of the new Wet n Wild collection, and so I was able to get this trio, and it's called, Hieroglyphic Heart. Here's what it looks like. Open it here. I think this is the only one that has an actual matte shade. But there's a gold, a matte dusty pink, and then a shimmery bronze. And here's what they look like. Really pretty. I'm really interested to use them. So first, I'm going to go in with a Wet n Wild fluffy brush here. And I'm going to go in with this matte crease shade. Does kick up some powder. Like a lot of powder, but I don't mind that for, I think this trio was like $2.99 or something, like it was super cheap. Whoa, it's really pretty. I'm gonna use all these shades today for my eye look. It's really pretty, really, really pretty color. You could put this all over your lid and be, it could be like one shadow look. I love Wet n Wild. They're like really stepping up their game. I always loved the, some of their trios were good. And then the ones with like the 8 eyeshadows, those were like the bomb. They're so good. Actually, I still have it. One of them. In my collection. Oh, this is so pretty. I'm actually too, since I have the palette right here and I'm using the mirror, I'm gonna use the XO palette. Use this XO palette. And I'm just going to use the highlight shade to just highlight my brow bone really quickly. Alrighty, and then this, they say the eyelid color. I'm gonna take that. And this is like a flat, and so with this, it's called the eyelid shade here. I'm gonna take this brush, it's called the blending brush from e.l.f. And I'm just gonna take it. Weird, this one's not kicking up any powder, this eyelid shade. Okay, and then I'm gonna put it on the outside here, and I'm just gonna dab it. And then blend it just into the crease a little bit. This one's very pigmented, holy moly. It's such a pretty shade. So gorgeous. This is a good one. Definitely, if you see the display or if you order it, get this trio. It's so good. I can already tell. So I'm actually just gonna cover my whole lid with this. And then I'm just gonna blend it up into the crease because I can. And then that fluffy brush we used for the crease shade, I'm gonna go back in and just go over it. Because I don't wanna lose that like dusty pink color. And then I'm just going to take the eyelid shade again, the dark brown, and I'm just going to go really close to my lash line and build it up. Alrighty, so I kind of left the first like third of my eye blank, and I am going to use what they call the brow bone, and I'm just going to use a little itty bitty pencil brush. I'll grab that, and I'm just going to pack it on to that first third of my eye. I'm going to brighten up. And I'm going to put it in the inner corner. I will have to do a Wet n Wild get ready with me, because they have such good products. And I just got their new foundation, and I'm kind of excited to try it because everyone like raves about it. So alright, just like that. And then also, I'm just going to use the same brush. I'm going to go in with that matte crease shade and go underneath my eye with it. And then on the outer third, I'm going to use the little sponge thing that comes with it. And I'm going to put the eyelid shade, which is the dark brown, on just the outer third. And blend it. Alrighty, just like that. Really good trio. Really, really good. Love it. So now I'm going to bronze up my face and do maybe a little bit of contouring. I don't know yet. But I want to use this new bronzer. It is from Essence. Look how massive this thing is. It's like huge. And it's their Sun Club Matte Bronzing Powder. And I have the shade 01 Natural. It smells like suntan lotion. It smells so good. Gets me ready for summer. So I'm going to use this. And a brush. It's hard. I don't want to like go into it because like the embossing is so pretty. It's more of a contour look to kind of chisel out my cheeks. I'm going to use the e.l.f. Contour Kit. And I am going to use the shade here. It's very pigmented, so I barely tap. And then I'm going to go in and blend up. I love this contour kit. It's so good. All right, just like that. So I'm going to use this brush. It's from L'Oreal. It's called Muse's Blush. And it's a pretty, like, coral color. So, that was a lot of powder. And I'm just gonna go over my cheeks. So now I'm going to curl my eyelashes and I will be right back. So for mascara, I'm going to use the L'Oreal Butterfly Intensa in Waterproof, Black Waterproof. This is what the brush looks like. And I'm just gonna coat my eyelashes. So I'm gonna set all these powders down on my face with the e.l.f. Primer Mist. Let's see. It's like white. Maybe it's not. Let's see the sprayer. Ooh. Doesn't smell like anything. Whoa! Woo! That, like, the sprayer, do you see this? Like, man, that's like a blast in your face. Ooh. Whew, man. I don't know if I'm a fan of that. It's not a very fine mist. Mm. No, it's not. Mm. I don't know about that. So first for my lips, I'm going to line them with the NYX lip liner in Peekaboo Neutral. So now I'm going to use the Wet n Wild Mega Lash Liquid Lipsticks in Rebel Rose. I'm so excited to try this. It looks beautiful. Beautiful. And now highlighting. I gotta do the highlight. I was able to get the new limited edition highlighter, and this one is in the Sweetest Bling. So I'm gonna take a little fame brush and dip it in. It's pink on the outside and there's like a white, almost champagne on the inside, the little heart. So now I'm gonna highlight. Oh, gorgeous. So that is my finished look. I hope you enjoyed. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe down low. And also, any info on the products I use will be listed down below. And I will talk to you guys later.